A 24-year-old female student from Fort Hare University has been arrested for the murder of a 24-year-old male student on the institution's Ellis campus. Police spokesperson says the deceased was allegedly stabbed in his upper body with a knife this morning. And remember that just yesterday, we were reporting here on the show on a grade 12 female learner who stabbed and killed a grade 8 male learner in Fochville in Gauteng. So we're looking to these two incidents, more so in light of the high levels of gender-based violence here in the country. In studio now, with me, I have Tiyiselani Mukhari. He's the founder of the Reach Learning Mentorship Program for boys. And on the line, I'm joined by Keitumetse Fatimata Moutloatse. She's the founder of the Black Women Caucus. Good afternoon to both of you. Thank you so much for coming through. Keitumetse, maybe let's just start with you. Your take on these two incidents.
So, thank you for having me. I think, firstly, what's clear is that the environment of which our schools are operating are fundamentally not safe. I mean, the past 3 years, we've been seeing an uproar in activism and public action against gender-based violence. And maybe as activists, our limitations is how we fail to broaden our understanding and definition of gender-based violence. When we speak about gender-based violence, we speak about violence directed at someone based on their gender. Both cases that you're referring to are forms of gender-based violence. I know they supposedly appear as unconventional, but even in the way they unfold, they are forms of violence. But I think what's most important in this situation is for us to really look and critically engage with our education system as a whole. And this is from foundation right up until tertiary level. We need to really do some careful introspection as a country to what extent are our schools and institutions of higher learning safe? And these safety concerns, do they to any extent hinder any form of educational cognitive development?
Mm-hmm. All right. So, Tiyiselani, your take on the two incidents?
For me, it's very saddening, I must say. I mean, I've been doing a lot of advocacy for a boy child. So when I get reports on cases of this nature, I really get concerned and saddened because, well, this case in particular is unusual. Usually you would see boys killing women.
The other way around.
But
yes.
Now it's a concern. But at the same time, for me, I think it's a wake-up call for us as South African, as parents and as leaders, to say, what are we doing for both boys and girls, especially at school? For me, I feel like we need to start investing on teaching them on how to manage their emotions. For me, these incidences of gender-based violence speaks a lot about how young people manage their emotions.
Mm-hmm. All right, so we don't know, of course, at this stage as to what could have been the cause, but I believe it raises questions, as I said, in light of the high levels of gender-based violence in the country. Keitumetse makes mention of safety in our schools and the institutions of higher learning.
Mm. There has been a lot of gaps when it comes to safety at schools. And the other concern is that when an incident of this nature has taken place, now you need to cater for other learners because they also get traumatized. They also get socially, emotionally affected, and the teachers as well. So clearly there hasn't been like safety measures that have been implemented. At the same time, my worry is we tend to want to implement safety measures and support measures when incidences have happened after. And by the time we do that, it's already late. When you try to attend maybe to a particular school or a province, the same problem is surfacing again in a different province.
All right, so we are reacting to the situations instead of being proactive. So, Keitumetse, maybe the question again is, what conversations are we having with both a girl child and a boy child? Because part of what other activists have been saying is that, listen, everyone has been focusing on a girl child, but a little has been said and done to empower a boy child as well.
So, Balisa, I think we need to also have very, very honest conversations about where the sites of violence in the country currently. I mean, we're just 2 years into a new decade, and we've already seen that the public schooling system has been brought under scrutiny, specifically around issues of safety. I do think that although this is a case of inner-based violence, yes, but we should not also run away from the unsafetiness of our schools. I think for the past 3 years, the narrative has been, to a large extent, fixated on women, particularly the girl child being a victim of violence, and very little work has been done on the boy child. So 3 weeks ago, we saw the very tragic death of Enoch from Parktown Boys, which really brought to center stage that also boys are victims of violence, right? Whether it be physical, sexual, institutional, or systematic, the boy child should also be incorporated into the conversation. I think right now, the most detrimental thing for us is to think that the issue of violence is really just about, it's just solely a gendered issue. Yes, it may be a gendered issue, but it also permeates throughout different genders and sexual identities and presentations. Right. And if we're not having those kinds of conversations, we then really find ourselves at a detrimental end. But lastly, I think it's also important that we bring in our schooling into scrutiny. It makes absolute no sense that we are having children being killed at a school premises, whether inside or outside the school premises. What culture are we breeding? What is the kind of culture that we are teaching our children that makes violence seem like the only option of solving any kind of feud or dispute between
us? All right. Okay, so let me just bring in Tiyiselani here. How do we teach a boy child to protect himself, but also to protect a fellow girl child?
Like I said, for me, it starts in the mind. If you can be able to prepare a boy child to be able to deal with their emotions, especially anger, in that way you can save a girl child as well. You can save a family, and you can save
once the emotions are intact.
Exactly.
It saves both of them. All right, guys, time constraints, I'm afraid we have to leave it at this, but thank you so much for coming through. We really appreciate your time. Keitumetse, thank you so much. Tiyiselani Mukhari, the founder of Rich Learning Mentorship Program for Boys, and Keitumetse Fatimata Moutloatse is the founder of the Black Women Caucus, talking to us about the issue around gender-based violence.